You want to be successful in this course, and I want you to be successful. These tips are included to help you achieve success. Tip 1, organization and planning. The first step towards success is getting organized. The more organized you are regarding your studies, the more prepared you will be for class, and the more successful you will be in this course. Organization is not always easy, but you can start by purchasing a 3-ring binder or binders, and as the semester progresses, add course materials to your binder in an organized fashion. And by the end of the semester, you will have binders that look similar to these. You may also use the Week at a Glance link on Janux. The purpose of the Week at a Glance is to help you plan what you should be working on and when, so that you don't fall behind. A little goes a long way in this course. So if you spread out your studies across the entire week, you will be more successful than if you tried to conquer the world in one night. Since each Week at a Glance is based off the lab section that you're enrolled in, you only want to use the Week at a Glance for the lab section that you are enrolled in. Tip 2, read the syllabus and refer to it frequently. Your first task in this course is to read the syllabus, preferably before we have our first in-class meeting. The syllabus contains a lot of very useful information, such as the course schedule, which you will need to refer to before every class and laboratory so that you complete all required materials before class. The syllabus also includes information regarding office hours, action centers, and required course materials. For instance, the textbook is free and available here. You do, however, have to purchase an access code for Mastering AMP, an online-based program that we will use to supplement our course, as well as an iClicker too. The syllabus also includes what all students want to know. What are you being graded on? What are your assignments? And when are they due? So be sure to keep the syllabus handy and refer to it often. Tip 3, ask questions and seek help. If you have questions, no matter how insignificant or dumb you think they are, please ask. Chances are, if you have a question, there are other students in this course with the exact same question. There's a large volume of material in this course that cannot simply be memorized. You will need a big picture understanding as well as knowledge of the intricate details. In other words, you will need to understand how things really work, be able to apply your knowledge, and integrate content across modules. For example, you cannot memorize all there is to know about the cardiovascular system without understanding how it is linked to the respiratory or urinary systems. Furthermore, the content in this course is conceptual, which is difficult for students that simply memorize. The benefit to understanding is that you will retain the knowledge for much longer than if you had simply memorized it. With all of that being said, many students find themselves having to change the way they study, from memorization to understanding. We have the resources to help you. There is a significant amount of support for you in this course. I cannot encourage you enough to take advantage of these resources. Here are just a few ways for you to get help. Attend office hours, mine, or a graduate teaching assistant's. You are more than welcome to go to any graduate teaching assistant's office hours. You are not obligated to attend only your teaching assistant's office hours. If you cannot attend office hours due to time conflicts, you may make an appointment. Attend action centers, action tutoring, and make action appointments. Talk with the undergraduate teaching assistants. They have recently taken this course and have been very successful and would be more than happy to talk with you about their study strategies. Post a question in the online help discussions and receive feedback from your peers, TAs, and myself. You can also help your peers by answering questions that they post in these discussion boards. You can utilize additional helpful resources, such as images, animations, video lectures, and more, by clicking on the LibGuide link. And review the following online how-to documents on how to study, how to form study groups and how to make a study group successful, how to construct useful concept maps to organize and condense content, and how to prepare for exams and test-taking tips. Remember, we are here to help you learn. If you have a question, please ask. As far as I'm concerned, learning goes beyond the content of this course. I will answer questions regarding course content. However, I would also be more than happy to answer questions that are not content-driven, such as study skills and time management. Tip 4. Have fun. The material in this course will be challenging, but it is fascinating. After all, we are studying how our bodies function. As you learn material in this course, relate it to the real world. Watch TV shows like House, Grey's Anatomy, New York Med, and so on. Listen carefully. Is what they are saying and perhaps doing accurate? By the end of this course, you will be amazed at how many errors you find in TV shows such as these. Furthermore, when you hear about health-related facts and new discoveries, please share them with us. Throughout your journey with us this semester, have fun, because learning is fun. If you work hard, keep up with the material, have a positive attitude, and always ask for help, you will be able to achieve your goals in this course. We are here to help you, and we want you to be successful in this course. Please let us know what we can do to help you in your journey through the human body.